Would you rather pay $650 or $66 for a smartphone? Simple. With the Appalachian Advantage plan, pay less upfront and then just a few dollars more every month. Better service, bigger savings. That's today's Appalachian Wireless.
The city of Paintsville is setting the stage for an assortment of musical acts and street vendors who will be in town this weekend for the celebration of both Alley Fest and Autumn Fest. We spoke with both Jordan Pelfrey, co-owner of the Alley on Main Restaurant and Bar, as well as Paintsville Mayor Bill Mike Runyon to find out more.
Yeah, so this weekend we got a three-day music festival starting Thursday night. At doors open at 5 o'clock, or I should say gates open at 5 o'clock, and we'll have music starting Thursday from 5 all the way till Saturday till about 11:30. We got some big names coming, like Little Texas on Thursday night, Alex Miller from American Idol. We got Justin Wells, Nick Shoulders, Kentucky Headhunters on Saturday, 49 Winchester and Tyler Booth, just to name a few. All the music's gonna be outside. We're gonna have a big stage out in our big lot. We got part of College Street, or actually all of College Street in Paintsville. We're gonna have some vendors set up. We're gonna have beer and drinks and food and a lot of different things outside.
Mayor Runyon, meanwhile, highlighted the importance of these events both for the community and for the vendors who rely on such events for their businesses.
All we wanted to do was to close some streets and give these nonprofits a chance to come in and make as much money as they can, because for 2 years running now, they haven't had that opportunity as a fundraiser.
However, Runyon also wanted to stress the importance of following CDC guidelines while organizing the events, as well as an opportunity for those who may not already be vaccinated to receive their dose if they so choose.
We have to maintain CDC guidelines. The vendors will have hand sanitizers, wash stations. Of course, they will prepare food with gloves. Masks are optional. We're not going to mandate mask wearing since it's an outdoor activity anyway. But masks are optional, but we would like for people to follow CDC guidelines. I would like to add that we have a group coming in. Ohio Valley Health is coming in, and they're bringing a mobile unit that will be parked right here in front of 404 Pavilion. And they're doing free vaccines and free testing. So anybody that attends the festival can get free vaccines, they can get free testing or whatever they need to do. And I think that's important, because everybody needs to understand we're not going to get rid of this thing until we start getting vaccinated.
For Mountaintop News, I'm Joshua Sloan.